His name has become synonymous with superstardom. He turned out million-selling records when his peers were still in grade school. He has single-handedly rewritten recording history. Don't stop till you get in a fight the night away. You can feel it in a cheese. Still, my face, these tears ain't drying. His dancing seems to defy the laws of physics. His fans are both loving and frightening.
I'd die if I ever got to meet him because he's just so great.
He waved at me and he said, hello, I can't believe it! He waved at me!
He's charged with energy.
He's got a lot of soul.
Oh, he's lovely.
This is like this with the Beatles.
He's so great until we see him.
You are the greatest.
He has redefined the term professional entertainer. He is simply Michael Jackson.
Like swimming, play basketball, catching lizards and things.
Michael Jackson's story is spectacular and intricate. It covers the more than two decades since he began performing. But any story about Michael would not be complete without including Michael's fans. And to let some of Michael's fans become part of this story, a contest was prepared by Showtime and MTV.
What would you ask Michael Jackson? There's an MTV contest riding on your answer.
Michael, what is your favorite vegetable?
Just think of the best three questions to ask Michael Jackson, and you could win a tour of Michael's home. A meeting with Michael. MTV's Ask Michael contest.
From all the contestants, Kathy Burke from Atlantic City, New Jersey, Troy Council from Tallahassee, Florida, and Erica Salisbury from Lakewood, California, were chosen to visit Michael's home and share their feelings about Michael and his career from the very beginning with the Jackson 5. Michael and his brothers and sisters grew up listening to their father, Joe, play guitar and often joined their mother, Catherine, harmonizing with her on country western songs. When Joe realized that their homespun rhythms showed promise, he began urging more and more practice. Before long, they had taken their act on the road in the Midwest and on the East Coast, including the Apollo Theater and an appearance on the Miss Black America pageant.
It's your thing, yeah, do what you wanna do.
discovered him?
I don't know. I mean, did somebody tell him to go to Motown, or maybe somebody heard them sing someplace?
I heard that Diana Ross was responsible for it in some fashion.
The legend was born because it seemed like a good idea at the time that Diana Ross had discovered them, because she was a big star, and Diana Ross would present them. Well, she did, in fact, present them. I'm not sure she discovered them.
Out in our audience tonight is Diana Ross and the Supremes, who discovered the Jackson 5 in Gary, Indiana. Wasn't it Gary, Indiana?
Yeah, right.
Stand up and take a bow there. Diana Ross. Diana, that's really a tennis fight. Those good youngsters are amazing. And the little fella in front is incredible.
And some people say Diana Ross discovered him. Some people say Gladys Knight. Some people say Bobby Taylor. But I know the truth because I was there when it all happened.
One day, Bobby Taylor called me up. He said, you got to come downstairs and see something. You're not going
to
believe it.
Bobby Taylor and the Vancouvers. Bobby Taylor saw us and wanted to bring us to Motown. And so we decided that we'd go this time.
We discovered the Jackson 5. It's a true story. They had won a contest, and as part of the contest, they won. They got to appear with us on the same bill. We were headlining. And Michael and his brothers, they got out there. So cute. Michael was incredible. He played, and then after we talked to him, and they said, you know, can you help us out, you know, get us into Motown or whatever? And we said, sure, we'll give it a shot.
It was Berry Gordy's fascination with early home video cameras that made it possible to record the Jackson 5's audition in Detroit. That videotape was then sent to Los Angeles, where Berry Gordy recognized the rough and unpolished group as potential stars. He immediately mobilized the creative forces of Motown to write and produce for the Jackson 5.
Boys, I want to sign you up!
Yeah?
Yeah!
Woo-hoo!
And he used, which I thought was a very smart move, Diana Ross was big in the public's eye, that he used her to introduce us to the public. Barry came, he was very excited, and he was trying to describe the group to us and telling us how young they were and about the little guy who was singing, who must have been here before because he had all the soul quality of someone who was much older than he was.
Jackson 5 started their career at Motown was unprecedented. Hit songs back to back, ABC, The Love You Save, and I Want You Back.
What's your favorite?
I wasn't even born yet.
Oh, that's right.
But you were.
Oh, thanks. Okay, yeah, but at least I can remember more Jackson 5 songs than you can.
Take me.
five young brothers from Gary, Indiana, have three number one records. Well, it's phenomenal. And that's exactly what they are. Ladies and gentlemen, my friends, the Jackson Five.
Their next single quickly became their fourth consecutive number one hit.
You and I must make a pact. We must bring salvation back. Where there is love, I'll be there.
I'll be there.
If you should ever find someone new, I know he better be good to you. 'Cause if he does,
about things like school?
Well, we have a tutor when we go on the road, you know, like she do about 3 hours or four.
And after that, we did what we did, have rehearsal at a sound check on the road or whatever.
Okay, let's go.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Some of the Jackson Five's early steps toward stardom were organized and guided by a young Motown executive, Suzanne DePass.
I can remember working out the choreography to I Want You Back in my living room. We would put the record on, and someone would have an idea, I'd have an idea, and we'd put it all together. In those days, we did it ourselves. They became so successful so quickly that none of us were prepared for it. We went from being able to go anywhere, get a hamburger, go to a movie, you know, go shopping, to being able to go nowhere.
The guest stars of the Diana Ross special, the group that has sold more single records in the country in this last year than anybody else, the Jackson Five. And from left to right, they are...
I'm Jermaine.
I'm Jackie.
Marlon.
Tito.
And I'm Mike.
Michael, now you are the lead singer of the group.
Right.
You're also the youngest. You're how old?
11.
Do they give you any trouble, your brothers?
Not really, because we all sing and... whatever we do it together as a group.
Now we'd like to have you hear some of their latest important record, which is my favorite, While They Go Off to School. Can you bear it? It's called Never Can Say Goodbye, and thanks for coming, fellas.
Mm-hmm. Never can say goodbye. No, no, no. Never can say goodbye.
Say goodbye.
Even though the pain and heartache seems to follow me wherever I go.
This is your roving reporter, Scoop Newsworthy, standing in front of the actual rehearsal hall where the Jackson Five are preparing for their Indiana concert. What? Hi.
Hey. How you going?
What's going on?
Jackson Five's rehearsing in there, but you can't go in.
J5.
But you can't go in. You're going to be thrown right out.
Stand and welcome the mighty, mighty Jackson Five.
Jacksons grew up in Gary, Indiana. So this concert was really a celebrated and joyful return to their roots.
I'm going back to Indiana. Indiana, here I come. I'm going back to Indiana. That's where my baby's from. That's where she is. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Since the heyday of the Beatles has the music world seen anything like the Jackson 5, about to receive yet another platinum record denoting sales of 2 million discs. These amazing little Motown cats already have 4 platinums to their credit, now being honored in Atlanta by Mrs. Coretta King and a host of other black luminaries.
Man of many versatile talents, not the least of which is always being a gentleman. Will you greet our special guest, Mr. Michael Jackson?
In the late 70s, Michael and his brothers worked their already perfected style into some of the best and most successful music of the time. The Motown years were a blur of hit records and professional growth for Michael and his brothers. Under the direction of Berry Gordy, they had become one of the most successful recording groups in history.
When we were tiny little boys, we used to dance, we used to sing before we even learned to crawl a wall.
Jackson 5 epitomized the Motown slogan, "The Sound of Young America," and fit perfectly the Motown philosophy of reaching fans of both soul and pop music. In their 7 years at Motown, Michael and his brothers sold nearly 100 million recordings. But in 1976, the Jacksons chose to move to CBS Epic Records.
So 5 guys went to a different company, 1 guy stayed at Motown. And we respect Jermaine's decision because that was a very difficult decision for him to make. The time we left Motown was a growth period for us because I'm sure that what I'm going to say, everybody can relate to, there comes a time in life where you want to grow or you want to branch and try something different. It was like a challenge for us. First time we get to produce a whole album. That was the first platinum album that we had on Epic Records.
The Jacksons have put together a film, and Michael has personally had a hand in this. I think, to tell you the truth, he's had a little hand in everything, not only the music, but the directing and the concept. And he asked me to look at it, and I said, Michael, we don't show films. What do I want to show film for? And I looked, and I said,
Going on your own opens up many avenues for you. And I think that's what Michael probably was thinking about, was the ambition that comes with being in this business from a child. And you see another horizon over there, and you know the best way to get over to that peak is to do it alone.
So Michael traveled to New York to co-star with his friend Diana Ross in the film version of The Wiz. And there, a professional partnership began that would change popular music forever.
I ran into Michael as one of the principals in The Wiz. I was a musical director of the film. He was trying to find a producer for his next album. The more I knew him, and the more I became fascinated with the idea of maybe working with him.
Quincy and Michael, now, you know what? All you gotta do is look at what they've done together. There's never been a success that could touch theirs. I mean, these two guys fit like a glove.
And I said, Michael, why don't we try, let's try this, we'll work on an album together. And we did.
Favorite album from Michael Jackson is the Off the Wall album. It really is. I mean, my favorite song on the album is Don't Stop Till You Get Enough.
I love that song.
Off the Wall was not Michael's first solo album. It was his first with Quincy Jones. The remarkable success of this album helped push Michael to further dazzling heights.
Look at all these pictures,
y'all. Look at all the stars.
There's Jackie Onassis. There's Sophia Loren.
And look, just more of a star. There's Elizabeth Taylor.
Michael grew up watching stars like Katharine Hepburn, Elizabeth Taylor, Fred Astaire, and Gene Kelly. Their strengths and talents gave Michael a path to follow.
They inspire him with their artistry. Now, an artist is always inspired by another good artist.
I think he's a brilliant dancer and a wonderful singer. And an amazing product of this universe.
I have absolute faith and trust in Michael's abilities. I think they're much larger than anyone has dreamt of. I think he's going to be one of the great superstars of all time.
When I met him, it was really love at first sight. I think when you get to know Michael, you understand the nature of his charisma.
Oh, I think he'll go on, and I hope this, because there are too few song and dance men around.
I never met him before, and I had no idea what he was like, and it turns out that he's the nicest person in the world.
I think Sean feels that Michael is a brother who is more experienced than him, so Sean tends to listen to Michael. I think Michael appeals to the child in all of us, and I think he has the quality of innocence that we would all like to obtain or have kept.
He's shy, he's delicate, and he looks at the world with the innocent eyes of a child.
I love you, Michael.
With the child's heart, go face the worries of the day with a child's heart. Turn each problem into play.
Love,
love is as welcome as a sunny, sunny day. No grown-up
a quality about Michael that is so rare and unique. He is E.T. He's not really of this planet.
Somehow Steven Spielberg talked us into getting involved in a song for an E.T. children's storybook.
We made it! That's what they thought. In came the roadblock. Cars and men. Police and guns. The net closed once more. E.T. and his friends had run out of time.
Whoa.
And up they went. E.T. and his pals. Up over the roadblock. Up into the sky. Wheeling over the rooftops. Sailing over the valleys. Higher and higher.
I'm keeping him.
The spell cast by Steven Spielberg's film and Michael's narration was strong. Strong enough, in fact, to capture another Grammy for Michael for his performance.
Of all the awards I've gotten, I'm most proud of this one, honestly.
He's just enormously gifted fellow. He's a really fine dancer. I didn't realize what a fine dancer he was until I saw one sort of tape that he did, which I thought was amazing.
Michael did not want to do Motown 25. Not because he didn't want to do anything for Motown, I think, as much as he didn't want to do television. Once he decided he was going to do it, the man was obsessed.
Yeah, those, I have to say, those were the good old days. I love those songs. Those were magic moments with all my brothers, including Jermaine. But, you know, those were good songs. I like those songs a lot, but especially I like the new songs.
You had to be in the old Pasadena Civic Auditorium that night because I don't think before or since there will ever be anything that would rival the discovery, the artistry, the expression. The entire audience was caught in a spell.
People always told me, be careful what you do. Don't go around breaking young girls' hearts. And mother always told me, be careful who you love. Be careful what you do. Because the love that comes to you. Hey, don't feel the chains of my love.
Was
incredible moment, you know, just dancing alone on the stage. It was so simple, so clean, so pure. It's one of the best performance things I've ever seen.
Michael was hot record-wise, but we'd only seen him in videos. And here he was, all by himself on stage, doing something that no one had seen before.
Something might throw advice. Just remember to always think twice. Don't think twice. She told my baby this to three. She looked at me and showed a photo. Baby cried, his eyes were like mine.
I think what makes him a star is he can do it and you can't help looking at him.
I had dinner with him, and I was tempted to say, Michael, how do you do that walk? But I was dying for him to show it to me.
Michael's real success that night was that he reached an audience which he had not reached before. He reached those who did not watch MTV or see his videos. He reached those who might not have bought his albums. And through this one television appearance, he suddenly gained millions of new admirers.
I have something I want to tell you.
Yes, Michael?
I'm not like other guys.
If you want to see the boy next door, then open up your door to your kitchen and look at the boy next door. Don't go see Michael Jackson, because he ain't the boy next door.
Although each new work from Michael was more successful than the last, nothing could have prepared him for what happened with this album. Thriller won 58 platinum records in 28 countries on 6 continents, and in America, an incredible 8 Grammy Awards. The total sales of the album have exceeded 40 million copies, earning a place in the Guinness Book of World Records as the largest selling album of all time.
Everybody always talks about the Thriller album. First of all, you gotta realize that thing sold almost 40 million copies. It's the biggest album in the history of the music business.
You try to scream, but dare I take the sound before you make me. You start to freeze.
What was really unusual, so extraordinary about that album is Michael captured the very young, the very old, everybody in between, whites, blacks, young and old, and that magic only happens once in a lifetime.
Yeah.
Thriller was on the crest of its popularity, there was hardly a day that Michael's name or face was not seen in print or on television.
He took everything and he put it down and he said, "The world, here I am, here I come." And the world said, "This is Michael, this is the man."
Through it all, though, Michael doesn't seem resentful. His love for his craft and desire to learn and communicate with everyone stem from the very beginnings of his career.
Mike has always been an observer, and in fact, I won't even put that in past tense because he's the same way now.
I think Michael is like litmus paper. He's always trying to learn, and he's so intelligent. He's alarmingly bright. He's very curious, and he wants to draw from people who have survived, people who have lasted. He wants to find out what it is, that staying power, because Michael is going to be a stayer.
I remember sitting on the side of the stage watching Little Dion, watching Jackie Wilson, Joe Tex, Temptations, James Brown, just learning, watching and learning.
In a cold sweat.
Learning from the godfather of soul.
Thank you so much.
The thing that I find fascinating about Michael is the fact that he smacks of my era of show business.
A 1, a 2, a 3, a 4.
He is the modern-day vaudevillian, so that subsequently when he did the two-man thing and they were doing the roadshow type of thing, his style fit in.
I see some of the moves that are reminiscent of Fred myself, yes. And that's the way music and dance should be. They should have some influence on a generation behind them, you know. And also for Fred myself, it's very flattering.
I mean, if I tried to compare him to, say, Gene Kelly or even Fred Astaire, something like that, I would do him an injustice. Because the thing that makes Michael great is his own style and his own originality.
Just be the beat. There are tickets, you better.
course, it's always nice to hear that one's work is appreciated by others.
Record of the year is Beat It, Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson.
The song of the year is We Are the World.
For years, Michael and I have been talking about a song that was like a 80s version of Bridge Over Troubled Water. It's a faith song of the 80s, you know, that would be an anthem. He and Lionel got together, and sure enough, that song came fast. We had to have that song quick. And I mean, he jumped dead in the middle of it. It was right on target of just what we needed.
We are the world.
Shalom.
We are the children.
Charlene.
We are the ones to make a
shalom.
Let's talk it.
Cause that's what we're giving.
Michael was going around quietly, directing in a very easy manner, you know.
Just believe, there's no way we can fall.
But if you just believe, no way we can fall.
Hello.
Hello. Do you remember when We Are the World first broadcast simultaneously throughout the world? I was thinking, really, what can I do to better the lives of other people in the world?
We Are the World. Incredible. The kind of work that would bring good vibration to the world. And I think he's doing that.
The power of music was never more clearly demonstrated than by the overwhelming response to this simple song written by Michael Jackson and Lionel Richie.
All right, let me hear
you. It should make a better day, just you and me. It should make a better day, just you and me.
As important as We Are the World was to Michael, it was only one of many examples of his willingness to act and speak out for what he believes in.
Michael Jackson, with appreciation for the outstanding example you have set for the youth of America and the world,
and after a serious accident during the filming of a television commercial, he created the Michael Jackson Burn Center in Los Angeles.
We're here today because of a little boy named George, a 13-year-old boy from San Diego, who is suffering from a life-threatening illness. It was always George's desire to meet Michael Jackson.
Meeting Michael Jackson for thousands, perhaps millions, would surely be a dream come true. And for Troy Council, Kathy Burke, and Erica Salisbury, their dream came true when they met Michael after a record-breaking performance in Australia.
Yeah.
news upon a star. Makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires can come to you.
For every one of us, there will always be hopes and dreams. And wishing upon a star to achieve those dreams has been a legend since the childhood of us all. But for Michael Jackson, the legend continues.
I've enjoyed the music. Of course, they'll never be able to replace the Mills Brothers.
Michael Jackson, no Michael Jackson.
Ben, da 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 da, Ben, da 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 da, Ben, to have a friend like Ben.
Come on, don't be looking at me. Come on.
We've been.